Ulva, it's a green seaweed. It's commonly referred to as sea lettuce.
The green is kind of what we're looking at.
Being able to take something like seaweed that's very naturally occurring and use it for something that farms need.
It has a significant amount of carbon and nitrogen.
It's a solution that really works for our farmers right here and is very unique to our location.
Here's a gooey duck. Oh, it's a siphon, one here, one there. I've been a shellfish farmer and researcher here for the last 40 years. If you start looking around, you can see squirting gooey ducks. Most of the animal is in the sand, and just the siphon is showing. The problem is too much seaweed, it grows in proliferation and just piles up on top of these gooey duck tubes. And we definitely have seen mortalities of gooey duck with too much ulva cover, and it's getting worse.
One of the big challenges that shellfish farmers in this region are facing right now is this seaweed.
Oh yeah, it's insane.
They were thinking creatively, like, what is this good for? And they were starting to think about maybe it could be used on soil. We want more nutrients in our agricultural soils, always have to fertilize. And so what's a problem for a shellfish farm could be a great resource for a farm on land if we can figure out how to make that happen and do it in a way that is both scientifically sound and also economically feasible. This starts with bringing it onto the shore, finding it a place to dry, and then transporting it to farms, applying it to those agricultural soils, and growing crops.
This is Deer Table Farm. We're in the Skagit Valley, and we farm 6 acres. Mixed produce, cut flowers. We were just really interested in it because, I don't know, this is unique, something that's more sustainable for the long haul.
We applied seaweed, tracked their crop growth, and did a bunch of soil sampling and all kinds of stuff on their farm, and then continuing to monitor their crop responses to seaweed application.
Our broccoli plants, that was our first crop. And then this year it'll be lettuce. So pretty.
Look at that one.
Crops were great. Our initial concern was that the saltiness of it would really throw things off, but there was no issue with that. The first year, it was like we barely had to water those things. The water retention was great. Hey. It's cool to be able to be at the market and talk about this experiment.
So seaweed affects the soil health. So
hope other farmers get a chance to experiment with it as well.
In mid-April, we received notice from the U.S. Department of Agriculture that the project was being terminated. We immediately had to shut everything down. And this was right as we were ramping up for our second field season. It's really 1 year of data, and we need 3 years of data before we can start to say what's gonna work.
I'm disappointed. We're hoping to do it, that was the plan, but the funding didn't work out.
I hope that it becomes viable for people to make and use.
Like, I know it's gonna work. The thing that's really frustrating is this was absolutely a win-win. It just makes sense from every possible angle. So we're hoping we can find ways to continue at least a level that we don't lose all of the investment.